anyone who doesn't believe that the female body is scrutinized from head to toe, come along with me as I tell you a little story about something called cankles. Cankles is a portmanteau of calf and ankle, used to describe legs usually belonging to women that look more like musical drumsticks than chicken drumsticks. The origin of cankles is about as ridiculous as the word itself, since it first emerged in our pop cultural vernacular in 2001 in the feature film Shallow Hal. In it, Jason Alexander's character uses the word cankles in the process of fat shaming the overweight leading lady in the shape of her legs. Next thing you know, in 2003, the word pops up in Glamour magazine, and the rest is, well, cankle history. And why are slender ankles a feminine beauty ideal? Well, because someone made it up. Up until the late 19th and early 20th centuries, women's ankles were largely hidden from view due to the floor-length gowns and skirts that they wore. But as hemlines began inching up with the turn of the century, new beauty standards for what ladylike legs should look like had to be established. For that, look no farther than the iconic Gibson girl, who was the beauty icon of that era, who was drawn from time to time revealing her slender ankles. Thanks a lot, Gibson girl. And it's not long after that you start to see all sorts of ads popping up for ankle reducing contraptions, home remedies, and exercises. Fact number three that's important to remember is that cankles or large ankles are not a medical condition. And as I established earlier with the story about Shallow Hal, it is not a medical term. Swollen ankles might be symptomatic of something else, such as pregnancy, poor circulation, or obesity, in which case exercise might help reduce the circumference of your ankles. What's even more important to remember is that less defined ankles are usually a product of genetics. That's all it is! Any decent exercise physiologist will tell you that you can't do any kind of spot reduction on your ankles. Which leads me to my final and most distressing fact, which is that more and more women are actually seeking out ankle liposuction in order to get rid of their cankles. Which signals to me that it's high time we knock this fabricated female beauty ideal off its pedestal so that it no longer has a leg to stand on. Because ladies, if we can't learn to love our ankles, how are we ever gonna learn to love the rest of us?